God never disappoints. Isaiah chapter 49 reads, "Listen to me, all of you in far-off lands. The Lord called me from my birth, for within the womb he called me by name. God will make my words of judgment sharp as swords. He has hidden me in the shadow of his hand. I am like a sharp arrow in his quiver. He said to me, 'You are my servant, a prince of power with God, and you shall bring me glory.' And I replied, 'But my work for them seems all in vain. I have spent my strength for them without a response. Yet I leave it all with God for my reward.'" We're going to begin this morning by singing, "Every Time I Feel the Spirit," a quite modern piece, but it's talking about the Holy Spirit coming into your heart night and day. Let's go through "Every Time I Feel the Spirit." Now let's pray. You've said to us this morning, "Listen to me, O Lord. Listen. We come in your house and we're here to share together the message for today, that you, our God, never disappoints. Lord, we pray for this world and we pray that you will guide us in our thinking, guide us in our knowledge of you and help us to understand better what you want to do. As we worship this morning, may you come in a very special way to meet our needs, to meet our world's needs and to share one with another. We thank you for opening the doors for this opportunity of service. And we pray that everyone who is listening, everyone who is sharing, will be blessed. And I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to sing song number 3 in our songbook, which is All Things Bright and Beautiful, All Creatures Great and Small. Some of us remember singing this in our Sunday school, perhaps coming to church, wherever we're found. All things bright and beautiful. Let the Lord speak to you just now. And now we're going to have the message from the band. God never disappoints. There's some beautiful pieces. And God uses the Salvation Army band to give out the message. It comes from the heart. And there's always a difference between an outside band and a Salvation Army band. You listen You listen to an outside band and you listen to a Salvation Army band and you will be blessed in a very special way. Our next Bible reading is taken from Matthew chapter 5, Matthew chapter 5, where Jesus gives the Beatitudes, the blessings. One day, as the crowds were gathering, he went up the hillside with his disciples and sat down and taught them. Humble men are very fortunate, he told them, for the kingdom of heaven is given to them. Those who mourn are fortunate, for they shall be comforted. The meek and the lowly are fortunate, for the whole wide world belongs to them. Happy are those who long to be just and good, for they shall be completely satisfied. Happy are the kind and merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. Happy are those whose hearts are pure, for they will see God. Happy are those who strive for peace. They shall be called the sons of God. Happy are those who are persecuted because they are good, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. When you are reviled and persecuted and lied about because you are my followers, says God, wonderful! Be happy about it. Be very glad, for a tremendous reward awaits you up in heaven. And remember, the ancient prophets were persecuted too. And now we're going to sing Who is on the Lord's Side? Song 992 in our song book. Who is on the Lord's side? Who will serve the King? There's an opportunity for us all to serve. And this is a reminder. God's asking you, who is on the Lord's side? important that we know what we stand for. And in the Salvation Army, we're privileged to have a songster brigade. A songster brigade is a choir, mixed choir very often, and originally they were part of the corps that taught the congregation new music. And sometimes that still applies today. But our songster brigade is going to sing for us. So my prayer is that we will be blessed as we hear the message.
Thank you.
So God never disappoints. In Philippians chapter 2 and verses 5 to 11, Paul teaches that the attitude we should have is the one that Christ had. He always had the nature of God, but he did not think that by force he should try to remain equal with God. Instead of this, of his own free will, he gave up all he had. He took the nature of a servant. He became like a human being and appeared in human likeness. He was humble and walked the path of obedience all the way to death, his death on the cross. For this reason, God raised him up to the highest place and gave him the name that is greater than any other name. And so, in honour of the name of Jesus, all beings in heaven and on earth and in the world below will fall on their knees, and all will openly proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. We read our Bible to be inspired, to dream big dreams. We see how amazing God works and can use ordinary people. We read, didn't we? Happy are those who long to be just and good. It's not easy in our sin-sick world to be good. And our children, oh, I can't do it, Mummy. But God helps us to be good. Big dreams are usually accomplished by small steps and putting to work the principles that we read in Scripture enables us to make changes one at a time, heading towards that final big goal. The key thing in living the Bible is the real way to apply it. It's a great thing of massive ideas such as, I need to love everyone. But how will you know when you've achieved it? It's not that easy. Children, we show and ask that when they have brothers and sisters, that think about Jesus as their little brother, loving him, caring for him, and helping him. You need to have a clear idea of what action you are about to take and make a note of what God is saying to you. But don't forget, always take it as a reminder that God is there and he is good. Okay, some of us don't find it easy to make a diary. And I like my diary, but sometimes you forget. And those small changes don't happen. So just think, happy are those who don't always get it right. But there's an interaction with God that he forgives us. So we ask God just now to teach us to be humble, to be those that guide, that help. And may our relationships with other people be used by God, and they're positive, not negative. My interaction in God's world, I will take the appropriate action to help other people. Are you ready to help other people? Happy are you? How happy are you? The encouraging word for you today is, you are the salt of the earth. Do you feel better now? You are the world's seasoning to make it workable, tolerable. But if you lose flavour, what will happen to your world? And you yourself will be thrown out and trampled underfoot as worthless. No, no. Think about it. You are the world's light. A city on a hill, glowing in the night. Don't hide your light. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let your good deeds glow for all to see, so that you will praise your Heavenly Father. There's an invitation for you today to meet your Heavenly Father, to give you the strength you need. But don't misunderstand why I've come, says God. It isn't to cancel the law of Moses in the Pentateuch, those five books at the beginning of the Old Testament. No, I've come to fulfill them and make them all come true. With all earnestness, I have to say, every law in the Bible, the five books of those, the first part, continue until its purpose is achieved. Wow, there's a lot of laws. And so, if anyone breaks the least commandment and teaches others to, he shall be the least in the kingdom of heaven. But those who teach God's laws and obey them shall be great in the kingdom of God. And then, if we read Matthew 5 and this verse 20, but I warn you, unless your goodness is greater than that of the Pharisees and other Jewish leaders, you cannot get in to the kingdom of heaven. Pray about it and see where you are on your journey. So as we come to the end of this time together, focus on Jesus. Ask him to speak to you and confirm your calling to being a Christian. I ask for blessings. I ask for guidance. And I ask for confirmation of all that you're doing. And we're going to sing what we term as the Stavely Anthem to finish off today. To God be the glory. Great things he has done.
He has done, so loved he the world that he gave us his son. be the glory, great things he has done. So loved he the world that he gave us his son. He yielded his life and atonement for sin, and opened the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he has done. And give him the glory, great things he has done. And give him the glory, great things he has done.
And now, let us close our meeting. The blessings be with you and all that you love. Amen.